Hello everyone, good afternoon and welcome once again to another special edition. Well, let me just say special edition. I'm saying that because if you look at my both sides, you can see that I have two very beautiful young ladies here. And today we're going to be talking about a very sensitive topic. And now that topic encompasses everything. We're going to be talking about rape, sexual assault, sexual harassment, even child molestation, and every other thing that has to do with it. So, right about now, I'll just let them introduce themselves. Let's start with the beautiful Melanie Opinion.
Hello, I'm Ngozi Bobo. I'm a public health officer in Nikki. I'm so happy to be on this.
Thank you very much for coming. We're happy to have you here. Hello, Pretty Queen.
Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. I'm Asomha Sandra, and I'm a biotechnologist to be making.
You're very, very welcome, Sandra. It's good to have you here. Okay, so without further ado, let's just get into what we plan to talk about today. So I'll begin with the first question. Obviously, we know that rape, it's very wrong. And we know that it has already become a law in Nigeria that if you rape somebody, you have to go in for it. You will go to jail because of that. But the thing is, rape victims are always very scared. And the rapist intentionally warn or try to intimidate the victims here so that they don't, you know, voice it out. And we know that rape has begun from time immemorial. It has always been there. And people feel so ashamed to talk about it or to open their mouths and report such issue. But I feel that we need to speak up. It's time for us to voice it out. Let's not keep it down anymore. Because we find this, maybe it might not be rape as such, it might be sexual harassment, it might be sexual assault, but in this case it is also intimidating someone, be it male or female, with the intent of getting bodily pleasure from them so that they can gain what they want. Sometimes it could be at the offices, yeah. It could be in schools, it could be anywhere. And this whole thing, actually, I'm sorry to say, for those who might not feel that maybe I'm correct or I'm taking a particular side, but I would love to state it here in the open that this has actually done a lot of wrong to the females. I don't know if I'm communicating with anyone of you. The females have always been the one who have to take the fall for it. They are always the ones who are the victims in this case. The other day I was watching the news. I think that was a Sunday night, and it really gave me a heartache because I heard on the news that a pregnant woman, up to 6 months. I don't know if you watched that. I don't know how people reason most times. How can someone rape a pregnant woman? Was he not seeing the pregnancy? Or is it when someone decides to sexually molest a kid? It's really bad. It's really bad. Even adult females are also raped too.
Yeah.
Or let's not stick to a particular gender. Even males are raped as well. So I think it's time to speak up. Let rape victims speak up. Let's forget about maybe some kind of crazy questions that could be asked by some other person who thinks that maybe rape is not possible. I think rape, more than 70% of females, I repeat, are raped every time. It happens right under our noses. And I think we need to be careful as females. So we are making this video to educate and also create awareness. Let people know that it's wrong to do such things. Now, if we talk about causes of rape, is there anything that could cause some other person to rape someone else?
I would say no. There is nothing, how would I put it, not necessary. There's nothing because rape has to do with the mindset of the person raping.
Yes.
Okay? It has to do with that mindset. If you say it's a social factor, what really can push people? Actually, the other people, either in that kind of situation, I have not raped someone.
Exactly.
So it has to do with the person's mindset, your self-control, how you think, how you reason. That's it. It's the psychological stuff. That's how.
Exactly. What you were saying was actually very correct. Raping has to do with someone's mindset. And to me, I feel it's also an issue, a psychotic problem. That person needs, in fact, that person needs urgent medical attention. In fact, if you ask me, I'll say the person should be locked in chains and kept in a psychiatric. Yes, yeah, no, this is my
laughing.
Yes, it's not normal, it's not a normal thing. Like you said, so many people have been in that kind of situation before and they haven't raped someone. So why would you even think of doing such an inhumane thing to someone else? Look, people think that it's only when you kill someone or you stab someone with a knife that you've committed a crime. But that is wrong. When you actually rape another person or try to have anything sexual to do with some other person, you have also done something wrong. Okay, so that's a psychological problem. Now, which brings me to another question. Some ladies complain that they are raped by their husbands. Do you think there might be truth in this?
A woman has a full right over her body. And as a man, your wife doesn't have, you don't have rights over her body. In the olden days, they had this kind of mentality that a man that is married, have anything he does is automatically wrong.
Right.
Sorry, anything he does is automatically right. But that is not true, because every day we keep on developing and the mindsets keep on changing. So that is where we came to understand that no man has rights to rape the wife.
Okay, so now the next question on my agenda is, does indecent dressing encourage rape or sexual molestation?
Okay, I would say, for me, my own opinion, I would say it doesn't actually encourage rape, because someone, a person has rights over what he or she wants to put on. Okay, if she wants to, he or she wants to groom and everything, it's her body, it's his body, and he has a right over whatever he wants to do with it. Okay, so yeah, I would say it's really a reason why someone should rape the person. Okay, I would say that's the reason, because there are still some guys out there or some ladies out there that will see someone dressing decently and not be moved by it, by that dressing. Okay. So anybody that will see an indecent dressing or see somebody pass by with something that is revealing and you are pushed to rape the person, you are not okay. So that person is not okay. So I will not say it's actually a reason. Most people will say, oh, she dressed indecently, she was wearing this, she was wearing that. They will take it as a reason to actually perform that evil act on that person. Yes. So for me, I would say it's not a reason.
Okay, thank you very much for your opinion. But I just want to buttress this point a little bit. Now, going with the trend of female wears these days, we have a lot of dresses that are so, if we were to judge according to morals, yeah, these dresses are morally just so wrong.
Yeah.
It's so bad. You know, a dress that a female will put on and it will show the exact shape of her body, and she will leave some of her private parts hanging out, you know, and it's not nice. It doesn't look really good. It doesn't look decent on the person. But I think no matter what anybody wears, like she said, it does not give you any right whatsoever to take advantage of that person and then try to sexually molest or rape that person.
Yeah.
Now, let's move over to child molestation now. So if somebody tries to molest a child, do you think it was because of indecent dressing? What do you think would cause child molestation? Because it baffles me, actually.
Yeah, that's why I would say, and I would keep on saying that this rape stuff has to do with the mindset. Because a child, you say a child is dressing indecent. Is it because of the full clothes the child is putting on that made you attracted to the child? What does the child actually have? that's a little growing child. The child doesn't have anything to say you are attracted by it. So it has to do with the mindset. So people just perceive evil in their hearts. And it has to just do with the mindset. So people are just not okay.
Yes.
I'll just put it that way. It's not just okay. There are still people, it's just like if you say the child, that means you can even rape your own child, your own children.
Yes, exactly.
It's going on,
yes,
like
it happens. It happens.
Even on the news, they are saying father rape daughter, all these things are really happening. Even mothers touching their son. All these things are really happening. So what will you say the child really had to make you touch that child? Okay. So I would say it just has to be the mindset, what you think of them. If you say rape is evil, is bad, then you do rape. But if you see it as a normal something and this thing, then you see yourself doing it. Just has to be the mindset and that's it.
Okay. Now, which brings me to a much more sensitive area about this. You know, I think as children, you tend to believe whatever you're told as a child, you know. So when you bring up children and you don't really tell them the truth about things, then it begins to register in the wrongest parts inside their brains.
Right.
Now, what do you think we should do to children now? Do we begin to sensitize them? Do we begin to preach sex education to them? Because I believe that parents will not find this funny. They think, my child is too young.
Yeah,
he or she cannot hear about this. I don't want to hear such words. But when you turn around, someone else is practicing the same thing on your child. Yeah. So what do you suggest we do? Do you think we should inculcate sex education as well?
I think this aspect of sex education, Nigerian parents most times they interpret it wrongly. So this sex education, it depends on how you tell your child. Like when we are growing up back then, there was this kind of thing they always say that when someone tried to push you or do anything to you in your private parts, that would be chukalaba, carry you.
Yes.
So you know, as your child is growing up, and as a parent, when you are there, you start with, see if someone should try to push your private parts, or should try to corner you to someone that is not meant to be, that you should report to me, or you should run away, or you should, if something
try
should
to
happen, if, yeah, but if something should happen, you should tell your.
Yes.
Then as the child grows, you find out that the child starts mingling with peer, with his peer groups. You start changing the language you use on that child. You start using the men thing on the child. That is when the child understands things more about sex. That even if you don't tell the child, he or she might hear it outside. So you start changing, you start using some matured language for the child. For the child to know truth. This is not right.
Okay. So in other words, you're trying to say that since parents are not comfortable with telling them the main words, they can start from little and use cold words for those things. And then as they grow, they can now change it to the main thing that you should be.
Yes.
Okay. So that's a good way. That's a good way. Nigerian parents, I hope you can listen and understand what we're saying. Okay. So the next question. So, does a parent's busy schedule encourage or facilitate rape or sexual molestation for the children?
Okay. A parent's busy schedule, yes, it does. It does affect the child, yes. Because when a parent is too busy to know what happens at home and in school, or to even know what happens in the child's life, you don't know who is talking to that child, and you don't know who is advising that child.
Feeding them with
a lot of things.
Yes.
Even the maids you put at home, even the teacher in school, do you know what it does with that child?
Exactly.
So maids, most like I've asked some guys, I've tried to get some, in the course of this
research,
I had to talk to some people, and so most guys told me that, oh, it was their nanny that actually touch them when they were much younger, and they've grown up with this kind of hatred in their heart. Even most of them turn out to be even rapists, say, because of this kind of pain they carry in their heart from children. So if you give your child so much attention, when this thing happens, part of this children's life, like when it happens, you are the first person they run to. Yes, they come to, like, just like the sex education she talked about. Once you start educating your children about these things, once it happens, they come to you. Not when you are too busy, when they come, you'll be like, ah, baby, I'm too busy with this, I have some things to do, I have to go to the company early and this. They go to another person to talk to.
Exactly.
And when they, what do you know the person is even telling the child at that tender age?
Yeah, and automatically someone else becomes that child's confidant, and
yeah.
It's very
yeah.
Okay, let's move on to our next guest. So do you think pornography can be a huge factor that contributes in putting the idea of sexual molestation away in the minds of those rapists?
Yeah, I think pornography is a huge factor that contributes to rape in society. This pornography we are talking about, most times teenagers, they like to pastelize what they see. And this pornography, most times what you see, it deals with your brain. So, and a situation whereby you watch a pornography and you end up trying to pastelize it on a girl or on a guy, and the person sees it, automatically, let's say you have to do this to the person. So I would say that pornography is a very good factor that contributes to rape in the society.
Okay, you know, adding to that, I think when a person becomes so addicted
yeah.
to watching
yes.
pornography,
because it's very addictive.
Yes, yeah. It's addictive in nature. That's why we advise our younger
yes.
ones not to watch this. Most of them are locked up in the house watching pornography,
mm-hmm.
and it keeps on building. And when it gets too much, they try
mm-hmm.
to practicalize
yeah.
it, and maybe they don't see anyone to practice it on. They start, you know, producing some demented ideas
mm-hmm.
and crazy things start, you know, turning up in the person's mind.
Even child porn.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Child
they have different categories for it, like
yeah.
she mentioned.
Yeah.
Even children, you know,
boys,
they have the
children.
One meant for children
yeah.
and all that.
Yeah.
You know.
And also, you know, about this pornography stuff, you can't really say, there are some people that are addicted to pornography, yes. They watch it every single day of their life, yes. But yet, they don't rape.
But
they don't
it
rape.
Affects them
but
psychologically.
Yes, it definitely affects them psychologically, yes. But there are people that don't still rape in this particular context.
Yes, actually, it affects a lot
psychologically. Yes, yes.
Well, especially when it's built up in
mm-hmm.
there and stuck in there, it begins to just bring out some ideas,
yeah.
you know, a better way of doing things that you cannot understand. Okay, let's bring this up notch a little bit. Now, do we see, or let me say, in our society at large, do we see sexual harassment as rape? You know, sexual harassment. I'm talking about sexual harassment could just be verbally. You could harass someone verbally,
yeah,
and it could be called sexual harassment. You know, it has different categories.
Yeah.
Now, in offices, when you want to get a job or something, and someone begins to use some kind of sexual terms, yes.
Yeah.
Now, do we really take it as sexual harassment and as a crime in this society of ours?
Yeah, I would say it's a crime, yes. It's meant to be a crime because you can't give somebody, no favor is meant to be given without getting anything in return.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't say, okay, I want to give you this job and you have to give me some small things before I get it. It's not right. You don't do that. So I would say it's meant to be a crime, actually.
Coming to children being sexually harassed, I don't think they have the willpower, of course, to say no. Some of them might not really understand what you're doing
yeah.
to them at that point in time. So saying no self is not even an option. That's why we encourage sex education. Once a person makes such a statement or insinuates something like that to the child is immediately supposed to run away or scream out loud or do something that will make people know that something wrong has taken place here.
Yeah.
But to say children have no power, I don't think they have no power to do that. Okay, now let's go on to the next question. Are security agents in our society, do they really help rape victims?
Okay, for security agents, some do help. Yeah, some do take it very serious when a report is brought to them that someone has been raped. But in most cases, when a rape case is being brought to them, they will still ask them what happened. Were you the one that went to his house or he came to the house? What
very
did you do? Where?
Nonsense questions.
Even parents said, at times, be like, mommy, someone touched me. Ah, please keep quiet. How is somebody?
Yes, some people are like that.
The mother of a raped child. Listen, so some people don't take it so serious. Like, how is meant to be taken? Rape is supposed to be taken very, very seriously.
Yeah.
Like the way now they are really talking about it in the news and everywhere. They want to start because the cases are rising.
Yes,
it's becoming alarming. Yeah. So the security agents at times they don't do anything, but most times they help do. Most times they do something about it. They go to investigate about this cases of rape.
Yeah, you know, I've heard a story about one of them. No, she went with her daughter to report a rape case to the police. And guess what the police asked her? A female police officer for that matter. She said, I'm going to say this in vernacular, in Pidgin English. You sure say me enjoy him? You sure say them rape?
Really?
It's really so and absurd.
And they needed help.
They needed help. And probably she said this in front of the rape victim and maybe she broke down in tears.
Yeah.
How can you say that to somebody? It's really bad. Because I think we need to stand up against this and fight against this.
Yeah.
We don't know what is happening. This society is turning into something else. I think we all need to resist this and we all need to make everybody know that this is wrong. So at this juncture, we'll have to call in Vanoye medical student who also wants to say something about this particular issue.